Hey, what's up guys, Dhunesh here from my Geeks blog, and in this episode I'm going to talk about how you can make your iPhone or iPad safe and more secure. I'm going to show you some settings that you should change right now. It will not only make your data safe but will also help you track down your lost iOS device. Are you excited to know how? So let's get into it. Before we start, make sure to subscribe our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified whenever we upload a new video. Create alphanumeric passcode. You should not walk around with an iPhone that anyone can swipe to unlock. You must set a strong password that is not easily predictable. Protect your iPhone with an alphanumeric passcode, so set passcode with your desired choice of length and choice of your alphanumeric characters. That will help you to keep your data safe and almost impossible for somebody to crack it. Use Touch ID or Face ID. If your device supports Touch ID, fingerprint scanner or Face ID, then you must use it to unlock your device. Enabling Touch ID or Face ID is much stronger security than a 6-digit numeric or alphanumeric passcode that you can forget or that can be guessed by a hacker with enough time. Enable data protection. Once you set up Touch ID or Face ID, make sure you use for data protection. Enable it for iTunes and App Store purchases, Apple Pay and password autofill to protect your data. In any case, if your iPhone is stolen and someone tries to crack a passcode, then a feature Erase Data can be more helpful to keep your data safe. This feature will erase all your data on your iPhone after 10 failed passcode attempts. Don't worry, you can recover data from iTunes or iCloud. So make sure you always take backup of your iOS device and keep it synced with iCloud. Enable Find My iPhone. It is a major security feature designed to safeguard your device. It lets you locate and protect your iOS device in case they are lost or stolen. Considering the huge significance, you must set it up on your iOS device. Find My iPhone uses the phone's built-in GPS to pinpoint its location on a map so you can track its current location from another iOS device or using a computer. Just go to Settings, iCloud and enable Find My iPhone. Enable two-factor authentication. It provides an extra layer of security to your device and data. Even if your passcode is cracked by somebody, two-step verification can save you as you have got the device in your hands. With two-step verifications, any user or culprit has to enter a passcode and a verification code received on the device. Since your device is in your hands, you can always prevent a security breach to your data. Disable lock screen options. If you think that creating 6-digit numeric or alphanumeric passcode would secure your iPhone, think again. Your locked iPhone is still accessible to any pro iPhone user, who can easily sneak into your device from control center or notification center. From the lock screen of your iPhone, anybody can swipe up to control center and have access to Bluetooth, airplane mode, camera, and more functions. And notification center gives you easy access to messages and updates. Moreover, if you have left Siri enabled on the lock screen, culprits can ask questions and give commands to Siri to get the information. So I would suggest disabling access to notifications, Siri and control center from the lock screen. Just head over to Settings, Face ID and Passcode, enter your passcode, scroll down and under Allow access when locked, disable Today, Notifications view and Siri. Encrypt your iPhone backups. If you sync your iPhone or iPad with a computer to backup your data instead of using iCloud, that means data of your iOS device is also stored on your desktop or laptop. I would suggest encrypting your iTunes backup to bring security level one step further, as it is required a password to access your encrypted backup. So whenever you connect your iOS device to your computer to take a backup, make sure to check the box of encrypted iPhone backup. There are few settings to change in Safari. Go to Settings, scroll down and select Safari. Here you can manage some privacy and security settings. Disable Prevent Cross-Site Tracking to stop websites tracking you across the web to advertise products and services. I also suggest disable Ask Websites Not to Track Me to prevent websites from tracking your browsing activities. However, if you have enabled this feature, it is up to the website to honor this request or not. You should also enable fraudulent website warning. Well, I would not suggest enabling block all cookies because certain web pages might not work unless you allow the use of cookies. Instead, I would suggest clearing history and website data occasionally to get rid of browsing data stored in cookies. Manage location services. Learn to say no to any app that asks for location access on your iPhone or iPad. This feature doesn't only enjoy your private information, but also drains the battery and high usage of the processor on your iOS device. In this situation, go to Settings, Privacy, Location Services and Manage All Settings. Last but not the least, I would suggest using VPN if you are using an unsafe internet connection at a cyber cafe, coffee shop, mall, hotel, or at any other public places. Virtual private network connects you securely to the internet and retains your digital privacy. There are some popular VPN applications available on the App Store, from ExpressVPN, IPVanish, NordVPN, and lot more. That's pretty much to it. Do you have any suggestions to make iPhone more safe and secure? I appreciate your feedback in the comments down below. Like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel so you don't miss such amazing video. Well, I am signing off and we'll catch you in the next one.